Ding dong merrily on high, in heaven the angels singing, ding dong merry the sky, with angel voices ringing, glory.
Oh, that looks really nice, Andy. Oh, yeah. Not sure about the singing, though.
No, well, that just goes with Christmas, doesn't it? Anyway, the most important thing is, what's going on the top of the Christmas tree? Is it a star or an angel?
Question. Well, the star was an important part of the story, but actually it was the angels that did all the hard work.
What do you mean hard work? They just fluff around and make silly noises with their harps and that's all they do.
It just shows how little you know about the story. Angels were massively busy all through the story. Anyway, do you know what the word angel means?
Fluffy little baby thing?
No, they were God's messengers. They were God's postmen, telling people the good news of the unexpected story.
Unexpected story?
Yeah, when you unpack it, Christmas is full of unexpected stories. I'll tell you all about it if you like.
Okay, but first, star or angel?
Angel, definitely angel. Go on, put it on the top.
Okay.
I'll hold it steady.
I love presents! Oh, fantastic! This is pretty, isn't it?
This is pretty, isn't
yeah.
it?
Oh, what?
Oh, that one's a bit boring.
Oh, leave that.
Yeah, let's do that.
Now, can I open them all now? Or do I have to wait until Christmas Day?
I'm afraid you're going to have to wait. Because actually, we're going to open one of these gifts each week. And it's going to tell us a bit more of the story that we're going to be looking at. But we're also going to use something else. We're going to use this picture here.
Oh, wow!
Really?
Yeah, what's that all about?
Well, our friend Sally's painted it for us.
She's amazing, isn't she?
Isn't she just? Yeah, and we're going to see through this picture a little bit more of the story as well. It's going to be like putting the pieces of a jigsaw together.
Okay, I see. So, this bit is the first piece of the puzzle. First chapter of the story, maybe.
That's right.
And we're going to look at that story between now and Christmas.
Yeah, and our final piece of the puzzle will go live on Christmas Eve, ready for Christmas. And that's when you get to open your presents the next day.
Cool.
But, would you like to open a gift now?
Yeah. Which one?
I'm going to go with this one.
Okay. Nice. Very pretty. Well, what we have is...
I'll put that there, shall I?
We have... an angel.
Oh, let's have a look. Oh, she's lovely.
And a lady. And a candle with the word hope on it.
Oh, yes.
Hmm.
Oh, pop that there. We could light the candle, couldn't we? Can you do that?
Yeah, I'll let you do it.
I told you that angels had a big part to play in this unexpected story.
Yeah.
So God has some big news to tell the world. He sends an angel down to earth to start the good news. Who do you think the angel will talk to?
Well, if you want to tell good news and get it spread across the whole world, you want to tell somebody important, like a king or a politician, or at least somebody who's got loads of Twitter followers.
Well, for a start, Twitter hadn't been invented then. Oh. But you're right, the obvious person to tell would be someone important.
Okay, so who did the angel talk to?
A nobody.
A nobody?
A nobody. A young girl in the middle of a small town in the north of the country. Well, away from the big city.
Okay. Why did he talk to her?
Well, for a start, that was the first unexpected thing about this story. God doesn't use big and important people to do his work. He uses ordinary people like you and me.
Okay. So, who is this girl?
This is Mary, and she's going to give birth to God's son.
What? God's son?
Hmm.
Wow.
How?
That's the next unexpected bit about the story. God himself, the creator of the whole universe, is coming to live a life on Earth.
Wow. So what happens when the angel tells Mary that she's going to be the mother of God on Earth?
Well, that's the next unexpected part. She puts her trust and hope in what the angel says. She tells the angel, I'm God's servant. Let it happen as you say.
Why would she say that?
For hundreds of years, Mary's people, that's the Jews, had looked forward with hope to a time when God would do an unexpected thing. She put her trust in that hope.
Okay. Wow. Just wow.
Absolutely. This is a wow, unexpected story of God making a difference. And over the next 4 weeks, we're going to look at the rest of the story. And it's unexpected at every turn, I'll tell you that.
I wonder how Mary felt when the angel told her she was going to be the mother of God on earth.
I wonder what it felt like to know that God had an unexpected and special plan for her life.
I wonder what unexpected and special plan God might have for your life. We're going to listen to a song now.
You can sing if you want, but I'd rather listen.
Okay.
Yes, this one tells us about how special this baby was going to be. If you listen really carefully, you might recognise some of the stories. Enjoy.
Enjoy.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you deliver, will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know, that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know, that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know, that your baby boy Mary, did you know?
song, isn't it?
It is. It's beautiful, really beautiful. Mm. Mm.
Let's pray. Lord Jesus, help us to see that you can work in us and through us in unexpected ways, just like you did with Mary. Amen.
In our previous On the Sofa videos, we've ended with the interactive Lord's Prayer. But for this series, we're ending with a special interactive Advent prayer that we'll add to each week as our story develops. Why not join us?
As I cross my arms, I pray for those who feel frightened, lonely and lost. I thank you that you bring hope. Amen. So, what's happening next week?
Well, next week, somebody has an important decision to make and they have to trust God and have faith that he knows what he's doing. Before we go, I know that you're a bit disappointed that you didn't get something to eat in your gift.
I know. Oh, fantastic! I love chocolate coins. See you next week.
Bye for now.